hope this show, as well as this segment, brings you something useful for your interior design and home improvement projects. This week's All in the Detail continues on the topic, hiring a designer. Before remodeling, consider hiring a professional to help you take the worry and stress out of your next home improvement project. Most people are somewhat intimidated by the thought of hiring an interior designer. They worry they'll lose control of the design or the budget, and that the finished room may not be what they wanted in the first place. Because this is such an important topic, especially to me, and there's so much useful information, I've broken this topic up into three-part series. Last week, I discussed how to find a designer. This week, I will discuss how to hire a designer. And next week, I'll discuss how to work with a designer. So let's pick up from where we left off last week. Once you've interviewed several designers, take time to compare their estimates. Don't base your decision on price alone. Keep in mind that differences in each proposal reflect variables, such as the level of service and the quality of merchandise. After the designer is hired, you need to address specific project needs and goals. You'll share ideas, and the designer will lend insights and observation to your ideas to identify the overall scope of the project. During this process, your design professional will communicate concepts and help you understand the design process, articulate your ideas, and help you to visualize the finished product. Discuss fees up front. Typically, designers charge a consultation fee, a flat fee, an hourly fee, or a combination of these pricing methods. Obtain all final quotes for your project in writing, and beware of lowball estimates. If one bid is substantially lower than the others, chances are something wasn't included. Trust your instincts. You'll be working with the designer for a long period of time during a major remodel, so if you don't click, it's best to find another. The more input you provide, the easier it becomes for an interior designer to respond with additional ideas and to create the space that will meet your goals. How much is it going to cost? Well, it depends on what you want. There's so many variables, including the size of the project, quality of products selected, and the time frame in which the project needs to be completed. Developing the budget is a partnership between the client and the designer. As the client, you should have an active role in developing the budget. If you're unsure about costs, your designer can help. Be honest with your designer about your budget. A professional designer assesses your needs and helps you determine where to spend and where to save, prioritizing expenses while creating an interior that is within your budget. Also, remember that not everything has to be completed at once. Your designer can develop a long-range plan, consult with you to establish a list of priorities, and determine a timeline for accomplishing your project. I know I've referenced interior designer throughout this segment, but these suggestions can also work when hiring any renovation or remodeling professional. For more suggestions on how to hire a professional contractor, you can check out my April 25th segment of All in the Detail, 10 Questions to Ask Your Contractor. You can find it on our notes page on Facebook, or you can email me and I'll send you a copy. Well, that's it for this week. Next week, I'll continue on this topic, hiring a designer, with part 3, how to work with a designer. If you'd like more information on any of the suggestions mentioned during the All in the Detail segments, or you'd like some help with one of your own design projects, you can call me at It Can Be Arranged Interior Design. The phone number is 404-392-7615. That's 404-392-7615. Also, the information given during the All in the Detail segment is now being published on facebook.com/housedoctors each week in our notes section of our profile page for our listeners' reference. And there's a new addition to the All in the Detail segment. Each week, we publish a video that accompanies the audio portion of the radio segment. This video is also on facebook.com/housedoctors in our video section of our profile page. Along with being viewed on Facebook, you can also view the video on YouTube. If you'd like to be on our email list to receive the link to view this weekly video, you can email me at housedoctors@925fmthebear.com. It's almost impossible to search on YouTube and find our videos out of the millions that are being uploaded. So these emails really help with that. So until next week, this is Jalon Burton, and design is all in the detail.